What is going on, everybody? My name is Mike. Welcome back to the channel. I am glad that you are with me today because we are talking about 16 of the greatest features coming to iOS 16. Now, these are my favorite 16 features. So grab your iPhone. Let's get started. Now, the very first feature that we're going to talk about here is going to be keyboard haptics. We've had haptics on the iPhone, I think, for at least 4 or 5 years now. And this new feature gives you haptics while typing on your keyboard. It's kind of weird that we just kind of never had it. So if we go into settings, we're going to go down to sound and haptics. And then once we're in sound and haptics, we're going to go down to keyboard feedback. And there we see sound feedback and haptic feedback. And we're just going to go ahead and turn on haptic feedback and you're done. And then whenever you are typing or using the keyboard, you will get system haptics, which is actually a great feature. They're not very strong, or they're not as strong as they were during the very first beta. They might have tuned it a little bit, but I think it is a very good experience that really adds a layer of immersion when you are typing on your iPhone. I would love to see haptics on the iPad mini. I don't know about you, but if that's you, let me know down in the comments below. I love my iPad mini. Number two is the ability to lock private photos and recently deleted inside of the Photos app. So if you go into Photos, and then if we see here, we go into Albums, and if we scroll to the very bottom here, we're gonna see that we have Hidden and then Deleted, both of which that are locked by either your Face ID, Touch ID, or your passcode. Now, this is enabled by default, but you can verify the settings on or disable it by going into Settings, going down to Photos, and then once you're in Photos, you wanna make sure that you have either Use Face ID or Use Touch ID enabled to unlock recently deleted and private albums. Then anytime you try and view either your recently deleted or your hidden folders, it will prompt you for your Face ID, Touch ID, or your password. Mine are basically just Wordle scores, so it doesn't really matter. Let's go to number three. Number three is lock screen customization. So new in iOS 16 for the iPhone specifically, you have the ability to go ahead and create a different lock screen. And for each of those lock screens that you have, you can tie them to a focus mode, which I'll get into more in a few minutes here. By the way, if you're looking for any of the wallpapers that I use in my videos, there's a link below in the video description. Now, the first aspect of the customizable lock screen is by adding your own wallpaper, then customizing the colors, the fonts, layering all the photos, and much more. Now, first, what you want to do is touch and hold the lock screen until the customize button appears at the bottom of the display. You're going to tap the plus button in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and the lock screen wallpaper gallery appears. Here's where you can select from all the different wallpapers that are either pre-selected by Apple, that are on your device, or in a number of different collections. Once you choose your wallpaper, it's then time to add a widget to your lock screen. So if we press down, we see that now there are three rectangles in the top, middle, and bottom. First rectangle is where you can go ahead and choose to either have things such as the calendar, time, date, weather conditions. I actually have my activity goal, it's up in there. Next here we have customizations for the time. So you have a number of different font styles for the time in addition to a number of different colors. And then here in the bottom is where you actually get the ability to add lock screen widgets. Now, depending on the developer of the app, which was required to support all the new frameworks in iOS 16, you can have a number of different widget types that are in here. Now, I have Todoist, this here is gonna be Fantastical, and this one here is going to be Carrot Weather. Then I have the ability to see my wallpaper and then also customize the home screen. So let's go to that customize home screen. And here's the home screen. Here's the original photo. I can actually change it to a color. I can change it to a gradient. I can pick a photo if I wanted to from all these different, my photo library. Or I can go ahead and add a blur here. Now if I go click on original, if I take off the blur, it just looks good with the blur. Click done. And then there's that lock screen and the customizations of the lock screen. Guys, while we're talking about all the great features, if you want to get more content just like this related to iOS 16, iPadOS 16, when it comes out next month, make sure you are subscribed because you don't want to miss out that content. Now, back to the features. If I hold down on the lock screen to customize, and I'm going to click on tie to focus mode, and then I'm going to tie that focus to my filming focus mode. So now, whenever I activate my focus mode for filming, this will go ahead and turn on this screen, which is great. And this gives you the ability to customize your lock screens. Really depends on your heart's content and really all of the different focus modes. Give you a little bit of a visual cue on what different, you know, what context you're in without necessarily worrying about context switching. All right, let's move on to number six with all the changes that are coming to messaging. Here in messaging in iOS 16, you can obviously send messages back and forth. I'm gonna say, you are awesome. And I'm going to put a smiley face You can put a heart, and maybe I didn't mean to send the heart. I could long press on the message as the sender and get the option to undo send or even edit. Now, undo send, you have the ability to undo within 2 minutes, and that message disappears, and then the person who you sent the message to gets a notification saying, Michael Caputo unsent the message. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and send another message here, and maybe I spelled something incorrectly. I'm gonna hold down again. I'm gonna go down to where it says edit, and maybe instead of iOS 16, I'm gonna be real coy. I meant iOS 17. Now, once I click the check mark, the message is updated on the receiver side. And if I look at both sides of the transaction, it does say edited underneath. And if you click on edited, it does give you the history of what was originally sent and then what was then received after the correction. Now, additionally, you have the ability to mark a message as unread by going to the message and swiping over to the right. And additionally, this is a total game changer. I found this one today. So now if you go down into settings and let's go down to messages and let's go down to filter unknown senders. If you turn that on, click on filters, you could then find any unread message for your filters. So this is a total game changer because you can now swipe on a message, mark it as unread, and then easily find it by clicking on that filter button to find all of your unread messages. Not sure if it's supposed to function this way or not, but it does function that way, which is great. Now, the next one is going to be the changes coming to the lock screen in terms of lock screen controls when you're listening to audio. So let's just say you're listening to your favorite audio. For me, it's gonna be Bulls on Parade by Rage Against the Machine. Here we see the player controls at the very bottom here. And there's also this glyph here, which is supposed to represent obviously the sound wave of the content coming through. If we click on the album artwork kind of shifts from the player controls, taking up full screen, and you're still getting the lock screen controls for the sound wave. And again, this could work for audio, it's gonna work for podcasts, and it's gonna work for video as well. Say like if you're watching something in the YouTube app, that's kind of cool. It shows the thumbnail. So this is a great way to get just better visibility into what your content is and how you're interacting with it. Now, next, we're going to have enhanced video scrubber controls. Now, this is going to work on not just the iPhone, also the iPad, and it does work the same way in Apple TV. Now, let's just say you're watching the best TV show in the history of TV shows, which is The Office. Now, don't argue with me about that. And let's say maybe you missed a section or you want to go back and see it again. You can simply just take your finger, swipe forward, swipe backwards. And the faster that you swipe is gonna be how faster that it actually scrolls, which is great. If you wanna still pause or rewind, you wanna tap on the screen once and then go hit the player control play button and go back. If you wanna remove or exit it, you still just swipe up. This is great, works in landscape or portrait. This applies to both streaming video, applies to live video as well. So again, it's a great way, quality of life improvement. That's really gonna change the way that you use your iPhone. Enhancements to FaceTime. Now, as you see here, I have a FaceTime call going from one phone to the other. And on this phone here, I actually have my iPad next to me. Now, I picked it up on my iPhone, but maybe that's not the best device for me. Maybe I wanna go ahead and, you know, either pick it up on my computer, or maybe I wanna go ahead and pick it up on an iPad, an iPad Pro, something that's got a bigger display, a little bit more immersive. Well, new in iOS 16, iPadOS 16, macOS Ventura, is the ability to hand off your FaceTime calls. Now, what you can go ahead and do is click on the little FaceTime glyph that's up here in the top right-hand corner. I click on switch, I click on switch again. And what it does is it hands off the call from my iPhone to the iPad. And you have the ability to switch back and forth between devices. I could actually even go back to the other device and switch back to my iPhone if I wanted to. And it hands off the call back and forth. There doesn't seem to be a limit to how many times you can hand off the call back and forth. So if you find a limit, let me know because I'm not aware of one. So you also get the ability to do live captioning of text, which works, I found, incredibly well. If you're on a FaceTime call with multiple people, you'll get the attribution of who's talking on that call as well with that text. Again, this is a great feature, again, quality of life improvement, especially if you take a lot of FaceTime calls. Now, this next feature is gonna be a throwback feature because it hasn't been around since 2018 when the iPhone X launched. And that's the ability to view the battery percentage indicator inside of the battery when you're not viewing it in Control Center. Now, to add this feature to your iPhone, what you're gonna do is you're gonna open up settings, you're gonna go down to battery. Once you're a battery, you wanna turn on battery percentage indicator right there. I enjoy seeing the battery percentage indicator and it is helpful to me just to glance at it and look at it. Now, I can't wait to see how this looks on the new iPhone 14 with the dynamic island and the always on display. Hopefully it looks good. It is very hard for me to believe that it's taken this long for the ability to unlock your iPhone 13 above in landscape mode or portrait mode, but now finally with iOS 16, it is here. If you have an iPhone 13 and above, you can look at it, unlock it in portrait mode. You can look at it, unlock it in landscape mode. Now, I think the reason why Apple's doing this is because they're making a game controller, but that's another story for another video. Anyways, new feature in iOS 16, iPhone 13 and above, you can unlock your iPhone in portrait or landscape mode. Now for our next feature, this is a quality of life improvement. This is about the ability to take your Wi-Fi password, which previously was inaccessible on your iPhone. If you had a Mac, you had to go into either some type of password management application that you stored your password, your router, or into Keychain. But now in iOS 16, you can click on the I or the information logo that's right next to the name of your Wi-Fi network. You'll see your password field, which is all hashed out. You'll click on that. It'll authenticate you either via Face ID, Touch ID, or via your password for your device. And then it'll allow you to go ahead and copy your password and then share that. I wish there was an easier way to share passwords that were not necessarily in plain text, you know, just what the password is. Maybe do some kind of QR code, but that is not available yet. I wonder if it works that same way for enterprise accounts. I bet you that's probably locked down. But if you know that, let me know down in the comments below. Now, this last feature that we're going to talk about is what Apple's calling lift and drop. And that's the ability to take any image that you have and lift the subject from the image and drop it into another media, another images, whether you're putting it in a message, it doesn't necessarily matter. So I've opened up my photo library. I have this image of my son. I'm just going to go ahead and click on it just for a brief second. And now I've actually have his picture on my background. I'm going to go ahead and open up messages and I am going to send it to my wife. She'll love that. And then boom. And there it is. Lift and drop. This is a great feature that's available now because of the machine learning algorithms that are on the device. It allows it to select the subject and detect where they are in the photo and lift them from the photo itself. Guys, thanks very much for watching my video on the 16 best iOS 16 features for your iPhone. Let me know what your favorite feature is down in the comments below. Make sure you're subscribed because I got the new iPhone and the Apple Watch Ultra coming on Friday and you do not want to miss out on that. I'll talk to you in the next one.